Our service continues on page 2 of your service bulletin. Unto us a child is born, alleluia. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hid. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Festival of the birth of your only Son, Jesus Christ. Grant that we, who joyfully receive him as our Redeemer, may with sure confidence behold him when he comes to be our Judge, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. You may be seated.
In this holy season, we celebrate good news of great joy. God has sent his Son to live with us. Hear now the word of the Lord as it comes to us from the Gospel of St. Luke.
And it came to pass in those days that a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be taxed, and all went to be taxed, each to his own city. Joseph went up from Galilee out of the city of Nazareth, into the land of Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem. Mary, who was great with child, went with Joseph on this long and hard journey, riding on a donkey. They arrived late one evening and were very tired from the journey. The city was crowded from all the people who had come to pay their taxes. Joseph was unable to find a place to stay for the night. At his last stop, the innkeeper told him he could use the stable, which was warm and dry. Joseph thanked the innkeeper and took Mary to the stable. Remaining seated, please join us in singing, O Little Town of Bethlehem, as printed in your worship booklet. Soon after they were settled, the baby Jesus was born. Mary wrapped her firstborn son in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger. In the land of Judea near Bethlehem, there were shepherds in the field, keeping watch over their flocks by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and the glory of the Lord shone all around them. Please remain seated and joining and join in singing the First Noel as printed in your worship booklet.
Suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill to all people." Please join us in singing, "Angels We Have Heard on High."
Oh.
When the shepherds saw this, they made known what had been told them about this child, and all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds told them. But Mary treasured all these words and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, as it had been told them by the angel. Please listen as our cast of characters sing the hymn, Away in a Manger.
Here ends our story, as recorded in the Gospels. But there were others who witnessed this miracle. Our story continues using a famous 13th century French carol called The Friendly Bees. Listen carefully as we sing about the other creatures who were part of that first Christmas.
Thank you. should not cry. We could tempt to sleep, my maid and I. I set the dove from rafters high.
Was the very first Christmas, and there in a manger the Christ child was born. It couldn't have been stranger. Shepherds saw angels and also a star. They came to see Jesus. They came from afar. They knew he was special, God's very own son. He came to the earth to love everyone. He grew up in time, the Savior, the Lord, to be worshiped each day, to be loved and adored. So now at Christmas, we all take delight in the gift that God gave us the first Christmas night. And the gifts we received and the ones that we give, let us never forget it's in Christ that we live.
We now invite any children in the congregation to join us here in the chancel for the children's sermon. As we sing Go Tell It on the Mountain, you can come sit with us as we prepare to hear the children's sermon. Please join us in singing Go Tell It on the Mountain as printed in your worksheet book.
You guys look fantastic, and y'all sound great. Do y'all know what day it is?
Christmas Eve.
Oh, man. So what does that mean tomorrow?
Christmas.
I am so excited. I don't know whether I'll be able to sleep tonight. Yeah, you're going to watch out for Santa?
Yeah.
Me too. So Christmas, at Christmas time, we have lots of traditions. And traditions mean we do things the way we do things because that's how our parents did it. And they do it that way because that's how their parents did it. And when I was growing up, we had a tradition Christmas that we would always wait outside the room where Santa had left the gifts. And nobody could go in until my father said it was time to go in. And then when we went in, there was a pile of presents for each one of us, and we sort of tore into those presents, and we ripped open the packages, and we saw what Santa had brought us and what our parents had given us, and it was just chaos. We had a Labrador retriever named Lonesome. And so whenever we'd like rip a ribbon off the present, we'd throw the ribbon and Lonesome thought it was his job to get it and bring it back. So he would do that. And when my wife first went to Christmas with us, she did not have a good time. Because at her house, they have a different tradition. My wife is one of five children. And so when we all grew up and people got married, there were 10 grandchildren. So at my in-law's house, at my wife's parents' house, there were five kids, five husbands and wives, 10 grandkids, and two grandparents, 22 people. And you know what we did? We opened one present at a time. That's what you do? I told Jennifer that was excruciating. Christmas is all about the presents, right? It's about giving. It's about people in love. It's about being with your family. I can't hear what you're saying. Oh, it's about Jesus. Why is it about Jesus? Because he was born on Christmas Day. So what's the best present we ever got? What's the best? Right! It's Jesus. He's the best present we ever got because... He looks after us because Jesus loves us, right? So much that God sent him to be with us, to love us in person, right? So don't ever forget, whether you open presents one at a time or all at once, what's the best present?
Jesus!
Merry Christmas. Okay, you guys can go back and wait. No. Don't stay right where you are.
Please stand. Please join us in saying the children's creed. I believe in God above. I believe in Jesus' love. I believe the Spirit, too, comes to teach me what to do. I believe that I must be true love and love like thee. Let us pray for God's church, for Christ's church, for all bishops, priests, and ministers. Let us pray for our Christ church family. Let us pray for our country, our state, and our city of Greenville. Let us pray for all who lead us, Mr. Biden, our president, Mr. McMaster, our governor, Mr. White, our mayor, and for all leaders in the world. Let us pray for the earth that we may learn to take care of God's gifts to us. Let us pray for those people who are sick or in trouble, both here at home and in the world. Let us pray for those who have died. Let us thank God for the many blessings of our lives. God, you know what we need before we can ask for it. Help us to understand that we may not get what we ask for, but that you always give us what we truly need. Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Y'all go find your parents and have a seat. You can be seated whenever you've got who belongs to you. Has everybody got who they brought? Merry Christmas. Walk in love as Christ loved us and gave himself for us, an offering and sacrifice to God.
continue with the Great Thanksgiving on page 6 of your service bulletin. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give him thanks and praise.
It is right and a good and joyful thing, always and everywhere to give thanks to you, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, because you gave Jesus Christ, your only Son, to be born for us, who by the mighty power of the Holy Spirit was made perfect man of the flesh of the Virgin Mary, his mother, so that we might be delivered from the bondage of sin and receive power to become your children. Therefore, we praise you, joining our voices with angels and archangels and with all the company of heaven, who forever sing this hymn to proclaim the glory of your name. Thanks to you, O God, for the goodness and love which you have made known to us in creation, in the calling of Israel to be your people, in your word spoken through the prophets, and above all, in the word made flesh, Jesus, your Son. For in these last days, you sent him to be incarnate from the Virgin Mary, to be the Savior and Redeemer of the world. In him, you have delivered us from evil, and made us worthy to stand before you. In him, you have brought us out of error into truth, out of sin into righteousness, out of death into life. On the night before he died for us, our Lord Jesus Christ took bread, and when he had given thanks to you, he broke it and gave it to his disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this for the remembrance of me." After supper, he took the cup of wine, and when he had given thanks, he gave it to them and said, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Whenever you drink it, do this for the remembrance of me." Therefore, according to his command, O Father, we remember his death, we proclaim his resurrection, we await his coming in glory. And we offer our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving to you, O Lord of all, presenting to you from your creation this bread and this wine. We pray you, gracious God, to send your Holy Spirit upon these gifts, that they may be the sacrament of the body of Christ and his blood of the new covenant. Unite us to your Son and his sacrifice, that we may be acceptable through him, being sanctified by the Holy Spirit. In the fullness of time, put all things in subjection under your Christ, and bring us to that heavenly country where with the Blessed Virgin Mary and Blessed Joseph, her spouse, and all your saints, we may enter the everlasting heritage of your sons and daughters through Jesus Christ our Lord, the firstborn of all creation, the head of the church, and the author of our salvation. By him, and with him, and in him, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty Father, now and forever. Amen. And now, as our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread. And forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, are the gifts of God for the people of God. Take them in remembrance that Christ died for you, and feed on him in your heart by faith with thanksgiving.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Eternal God, Heavenly Father, you have graciously accepted us as living members of your Son, our Savior, Jesus Christ, and you have fed us with spiritual food in the sacrament of his body and blood. Send us now into the world in peace, and grant us strength and courage to love and serve you with gladness and singleness of heart, through Christ our Lord. Amen. May God, who sent his angels to proclaim the glad news of the Savior's birth, fill you with joy and make you heralds of the gospel. And the blessing of God Almighty, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you forever. Amen.